Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Guys, today we're going to be trying out a new bait. It's new to me at least. I think it's been out on the market now for a few months. It's called the Z Man Willow Vibe. It's kind of the next level chatterbait here. I'll get you guys a close-up of it right here. You guys can see that. Has a willow leaf shaped blade. This one is it's called the albatross. That's the color. It's kind of a silver on top, white eye, and a big white bottom. It's got the hook keeper on it that's wire like most Z-Man products. I've never fished this bait. I've only seen it this one time in a tackle store here, but we're going to give it a try out here today on the honey hole, trying a few different techniques with it. I hear you can fish this bait like a chatterbait, chunk and wind. Here you can fish it basically letting it flutter to the bottom and hopping it up just like you would kind of like a jig bite. We're just going to try all kinds of different stuff with it. We may throw some Ned rig bodies on it. We may throw a craw on it. Swim baits, grubs. We're gonna just try a few, two or three different things on it. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation for the Willow Vibe. Let's see what we can do on it, guys. Guys, we're down here at the honey hole. We're going to try out this new Willow Vibe bait by Z Man, and I'm going to be throwing this on an underspin 8-pound test because it's kind of finesse, ultralight presentation. Anyway, I've rigged this up with a Yum little craw worm. Hollow body. I use this a lot as a jig trailer, so let's get after it out here and see what we can come up with. I've got my front facing camera on as well as the rear facing, and I'm just gonna reel this thing slow and kind of tick it across the bottom. This thing appears to want to kind of come to the top of the water column. Maybe that blade causes it to want to do that. There's a lot of kind of spring looking pond scum coming to light out here right now. I don't know if that's a fish or if I'm in the moss. I think I was in the moss. Definitely feel it on the bottom, and when you're reeling this dude, you can sure feel that little willow blade ticking. That's a good looking little bait in the water, I'll tell you that. That's gonna be awesome. We just gotta get where the fish are. Just got to get where the fish are. I'm still not used to the weight of this thing. It feels like you got grass or moss or something on there when you really don't. This might be a good jig trailer as well. Guess we'll know when we get a bite. Feel that thing. I don't know if you guys can see the end of my rod or not. You can feel that thing ticking across there just like a chatterbait. Well, I'll tell you what, if I was a bass, I think I'd eat that up. Let's move on around a little bit, see what we can find. I think this thing's gonna be a pretty good deal if we can just figure out how to fish it, where to fish it, when to fish it, you know, all the fishing questions. We're going to try over here and see what we can come up with. Hopefully not get y'all blown over again. All right, let's give her a shot. Oh, nose is kind of running today. Tell you what, that crawdad right there, I could see that with a little old small Ned head or something, 16th of an ounce or so, in a bed. Ooh, that thing would be deadly. Maybe I'm just not selling it right on this willow vibe. Man, I don't know if you guys can see that thing in the water, but it just going back and forth, just whipping like that. Looks pretty good. I'm just barely rolling that thing. I can feel it vibrating on the end of my line. Looks good. Them little pinchers are just flopping around like that, going all over. We'll just keep moving. See if we can find one. Won't stay the crawdad today. There's a log laying right out there. Let's try that. Get you guys squared away there. Maybe I won't fall over. A lot of grass in this pond and a lot of old green funky moss coming in, I guess, with the temperature changes and whatnot. I think I'm hitting bottom there. I guess we'll see here in a second. Yeah, I believe I picked up a willow leaf there. Let's get down this way a little bit. I had one chase at that time. He bumped it a couple times. There's one right there. He said, I think I'll try that crawfish. I'll tell you what, he ain't very big, but that sucker is marked up beautifully. I mean, I want you guys to take a look how pretty that fish is. I mean, he's a specimen of beauty. You're gonna grow up and be a gorgeous fish. big, gorgeous fish. He liked that crawfish. Anytime you get a new lure, it just takes a little bit of time to kind of figure out how to retrieve it. I'm just getting that blade to vibrate. And just as soon as I get it vibrating, I'm just slowing it down and letting it try to kind of tick along the bottom. If you overwork it, it does try to rise up to the top, which I could see with a swim bait on there. When the fish were schooling, burning it and then stopping it, burning it and then stopping it, burning it and it coming to the top and then stopping it and letting it sink and then burning it. I think that'd be on point right there. Now this bait is not weedless. You guys can see it here up close. It's got an open hook, got a willow leaf, a little ball head jig. So it's kind of a combination of a whole lot of good things. I think it ought to work pretty good once we figure it out. No fish on it right there. So he wanted a little piece of it. Little booger. Nice little bass, couple pounder. Little willow vibe fish. On the yum. Hollow body crawfish. I'm just pitching that thing out there and letting it fall just a little bit and moving it just enough to get the blade vibrating on it. Like I said, if you overwork it, it'll rise to the top. On a pond or a lake that had a little more clear of a bottom, I'd probably pause and start and pause and start retrieve. But it's daggum grassy and mossy out here right now. I don't think we'd do any good doing that. Man, that wind's blowing today. Well, guys, let's move on down the pond, see what we can come up with. I wanted to first tell you guys about a new little series that I'm going to be doing in the up and coming days. It's going to be called Old School Lures and Techniques. We're going to be using three or four different baits. We'll do parts 1, 2, 3, and 4 probably with this technique. Probably going to use one of the original cream worms, probably throw maybe a beetle spin, maybe some inline spinners, and then maybe a silver minnow by Johnson. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation for that new series. We'll probably put it under its own playlist. Not sure what we're going to call it yet. Probably just call it old school fishing or something like that. So we're going to move down the pond, try to catch some more fish. So you guys hang tight. And you could use this on a regular bait caster, presentation with no problem. I'm just throwing it on this little underspin with a 8-pound test line on it. I'm just trying to get better at using this rod and reel and this light line. I'm kind of like a bull in a china closet. I break a lot of line by setting the hook because I'm still learning. I've been fishing my whole life, but I'm still learning. There we go. Oh, I missed him. He hit it twice. He hit it the first time kind of light. Second time he hit it a little heavier. But anyway, I hope you guys are enjoying the channel here. If you haven't subscribed, I'd invite you to do so just by clicking that subscribe button. Tell a friend about us as well. If you'll click that like button and let us know that you're liking our videos, we'd appreciate that as well. Drop us a comment. We like to discuss things. If you'll let us know any videos or anything that you'd like to see, we'd be more than glad to try and do those for you. Tell somebody about us. We appreciate that as well. We're going to be giving away some fishing trips here pretty soon. Probably going to do a giveaway out to Squaw Creek, a day of fishing. I'm going to give up my back seat to somebody. And do some fishing. And another thing I'm probably going to do, this is going to be probably for Texas bass holes exclusively. If you're not a member of that Facebook page, you'll want to get in there, Texas Bass Holes on Facebook, man. It's a great group. I'm going to give away a day of fishing with me right here at the Honey Hole. We'll bank fish and I'll got a two-man boat. We'll put the two-man in out here and we'll do some fishing from the boat and the bank. And if there's any techniques you guys want to practice or learn, you're not sure about, this is a great place to do it. And I don't often do this, but I will provide a shore lunch. We'll catch a few little old fish and we'll have some fresh caught fish and probably some fried potatoes and some homemade cornmeal hush puppies with jalapenos in them. So y'all stay tuned for that giveaway. That'll be coming up here on that video series I was telling you about, the old school techniques. We'll be doing that coming up here pretty quick. You never know, you might get out here and catch that 13 pounder that lives in here. All right, boys and girls, we're out on the big point here. Throwing into this wind, I don't know how much ground we're gonna be able to make up. Maybe we can catch a fish or two out here. Tell you what, I like this little old bait so far. I can see lots of advantages of it. Man, I bet you when it comes dock skipping time, you skip this thing up under a dock with this little old crawl on it, or a little Ned, some type of a Ned bug or something like that. Man, I bet it is going to be, it's going to be seriously on. Even with a Senko. See, I got one right there taking it off. I don't know if you guys can see that or not with the glare on the water, but he liked it. We'll let it sink just a little bit. But, yeah, it's got that little bit of vibration on there. Skip really good like a chatterbait. Of course, this thing here I've got on there, it ain't skipping very good because it's got 8 legs and 2 big old floppy claws on it. A couple antennas. Dadgum, we hit another one right there. He about jerked her britches down there. Caught me off guard there a little bit. About to have to get a new crawl. That narrow's about done his deal, I think. But when we go back, we'll get a twin tail grub or a swim baiter. 2.5 or 3.5 inch swim bait put on there. Got a buddy I made the other day through Texas Bass Holes. James, he's from Colorado. Y'all seen him in the Squaw Creek with a Texas Bass Hole video the other day. He made me some swim baits and some twin tail grubs. They're kind of in a, I don't know what color you'd call it. I'd kind of call it a cotton candy. They're kind of a pink looking color. They've got black and silver and either maroon or pink looking glitter, and it makes them look pink overall. Really good looking bait. We may try that. We'll give another cast or two here. Ooh, had to steer that one out of the trees. Let it sink a little bit and then we'll see if we can't catch one here. Just barely ticking that thing. Well, let's make about 2 more casts and then we'll go change baits with it. We know it'll catch fish with a crawfish on it. We've done it. Got one right there. Just got heavy on us. He ain't a big giant, but he's big giant fun. You know, I will say this, this bait keeper on this thing works pretty good because I've yet to have my worm come down on it. It's done a real good job of keeping my plastics up on my hook. Even when the fish are biting it. All right, let's go down there to the truck and let's change colors and types of baits. And we'll continue on with this Willow vibe from Z Man. All right, guys, we made it back to the truck. I'm taking this little crawdad off and I'm gonna put on some of these baits that James made me. Let me pull them out of the bag here and show you guys the difference. So he made me some, I'm gonna call them 2.5 inch, 3.5 inch, and then twin tail grubs here. You guys can see that. really a good looking color. They look like they've got pink and black and silver glitter in them. Let you guys take a close look at them. Good looking baits. I'm gonna put one of each in my pocket. We're gonna thread them dudes on there. Now I'm gonna tell you, it's gonna be real important that you get this bait on there straight, because this little Z Man, it's already wanting to, you know, come to the top. When you put that bait on there, when you put it up on that hook keeper, kind of pinch it and pick it up and slide it forward and get it over the hump. And I think you'll be a lot better off on your hook keeper. I can't take credit for that. I got to give credit to that for Chad Hoover for that from Kayak Bassin'. He's the one that I've seen that on his videos, and I've tried it and it works really well. So if you guys haven't checked out Kayak Bassin', if you're a kayak fisherman, Chad Hoover, he's one of the man on the kayak. So check him out, and I'll try to put a link up here at the top up here for that Kayak Bass Fishing. So you guys go try that out. Stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. We're gonna throw a twin tail grub at the honey hole. We're gonna give her a toss out there. Real shallow here. Probably less than 2 foot deep. Aquatic vegetation is probably 6 inches off the bottom, so realistically we're running this thing in about 6 to 8 inches of water if you account for the vegetation on the bottom and the shallowness of it. I'm just gonna get over here and see if we can't catch one. It's gonna be even more shallow over there, because when the pool's full, that ain't but 6 inches deep over there. The water ought to be a little warmer over here. It's a little darker and a little shallower. It ought to heat up, I'd think, a lot quicker. I think I must have picked up some junk on the bottom there. All right, let's move on. All right, guys, let's see what we can do over here with this twin tail grub. It's mighty windy out here. Weather's pretty, it's just windy. There we go. Little booger there said he wanted some. Well, that was on the twin tail. I'm gonna have to call it cotton candy. I'm gonna have to get with James and ask him what he calls that color, but looks like a cotton candy to me. Tell you what, let's change over to one of these swim baits. I like that little old grub. It's got good double tail action, but I want to go ahead and get one of these swim baits done. Let's go with a smaller one first. When you put this on there, you need to make sure that you bring your hook out of the top, because the way this thing runs, you're going to want your tail to be setting like that, not the opposite way. So we'll get over here and chunk this swim bait a little bit. I'm suspecting it probably won't be quite as out to float up as that twin tail grub. It's gonna look like a little old minnow just kind of tooling along there, minding his own business till a fish comes along, tries to eat him. Bottom feels kind of funny there. Like I was picking up greenery though, looks like. Well, let's try over that old log over there, and then we'll move on down a little further. We'll spin around or do something. I believe that's probably the smallest bass I've ever caught in this pond. Sucker wasn't 3 inches long. He hit it like he meant it though. All right, let's move on around the pond to a different spot. Y'all hang in there. Hey guys, y'all remember, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, we appreciate it. Click that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up and ring that notifications bell, so when we put out a new video, you'll know. We're out here on the old Willow vibe with the Greenfish Nation. All right, guys, we're gonna get down here on the shallow end of the pond. We're gonna chunk this Willow vibe around here a little bit. See what we can do down here in this part of the world. Remember, this thing wants to walk to the top. Now, it ain't as bad with this swim bait as it was that twin tail grub. We missed one right there. Now, he did get my britches jerked down a little bit. But I'm gonna push it back up. See if I can get view of this in the water here for you guys. I'm gonna push that back up and we're gonna be back in business. I'm just wanting to roll this thing just fast enough to make it vibrate. We're gonna throw this swim bait on there a couple more times, and then I've got a couple of, there's one right there. That sucker came right up there and flashed on it, just pretty as you please. He's like, man, I can't believe I had a hook in it. That's a little nicer fish there than we've been catching. This one here weighed a couple pounds at least. Not a bad little fish. Anyway, like I said, we'll throw the swim bait on it a couple more times, and then I'm gonna throw a Senko on there. Just something straight, smooth action, just to see what it's gonna do. Like I said, we can do that with a Ned rig, or yeah, you can see that thing, it's just getting western out there. Let's go get that Senko and try it out. We know it'll catch fish with what we got on here. So step over here and get this. I got a red one. And I also got a trick worm. I'll tell you what, let's do. I'm just gonna pinch off about tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna pinch off about 3 inches. Get you guys over here. I pinched off about 3 inches of this tomato seed Senko that I got from Johnny, my buddy down there in Mount Vernon. Tomato seed, it's got red, gold, and silver glitter in it, and that's what it's going to look like. Little straight tail. We're going to get out there and see what we can't get done on it. I bet that's going to be a humdinger, too. Especially this spring with that red. It may be a little early for the red right now, but we may not be. That looks pretty good coming across there. Notice if you flip it or if you reel it too fast, it not only wants to come to the top, but it also wants to flip over. So I'm gonna slow her down. Man, that looks good. Little old fish jumped right on it out there. He liked that pretty good. There's another one for the Willow Vibe from Z Man. Another little old fish. I want to show you guys something. See how he's starting to turn red on them lips right there? They start turning red on their lips. Old timers say it's time to start throwing red. So, well, we might be throwing the right color after all. Well, let's see if we can't get another one or two. Well, this acts like this might be a little improvement in size here. Maybe not, might just have him hooked wrong. No, I think he's about the same size as the others. Yep. Just got him in the corner of the mouth. I thought for a second we might have had a little better fish than that. See them lips, guys? Them red lips there. Red lips. I don't know if y'all saw that or not, but he wanted it. All right, guys. I think that's gonna be it for us today. I think we've done our due diligence out here. Little old fish there's got a few little black spots on him. Look there. Got them red lips too. Well, guys, that about wraps it up for the Willow Vibe down here at the Honey Hole. I appreciate you guys joining us today. Remember what I said about the upcoming series, the old school baits. I've stopped and purchased those, the ones that we're going to use for sure. I have got a set of these whiptail blue fox. They're 1/8 ounce little inline spinners. They're size 1 hooks. I grew up fishing these with Meps brand, but I couldn't find a Meps brand bucktail. Another lure that I never went to a pond without was these two right here. If you guys can see those are your beetle spins. These are also 1/8 ounce size 1, just a Colorado leaf blade on them. It comes with a couple extra tails. One of them has red dots on it, and the other two don't. But anyway, that'll be our number 2 bait that we'll use in part 2 of old school techniques. Then I bought this these little cream worms here. If I can get one where you guys can get a little better look at it. This is the original soft plastic right here. I guess I should turn it that way. These are actually manufactured in Tyler, Texas, just about 50 miles from me. Was invented by a gentleman by the name of Nick Cream back in 1949. They've been catching big bass since their invention. But anyway, those will be coming up in the next few days and weeks. Old school fishing techniques part 1, 2, and 3. But I appreciate you joining us here today at the Honey Hole, and also remember what I said about giving away some fishing spots on the boat. Various lakes, probably do Welch, Squaw Creek, Fork, and probably one out to OH Ivy. Those will be coming up in the next few days, and the rules to qualify for those will also be coming up. But y'all be sure you hit that subscribe button down there. Give us a little thumbs up. Ring that little notifications bell so you'll know when we drop these videos. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish each and every one of you tight line.